for daily ask Reddit, 60y/o and older, what is your biggest should have done that differently in life? What's the better way? I asked my 88-year-old grandma this, and she said to stop placing value on what other people think of you. Recognize this is your life, and get on with it. Do the things you want to do. This is probably one of the hardest, yet most satisfying and liberating realizations you could have. Asked my mother, 63, the same thing 1 month before she died in hospice of cancer. She said she spent far too much time thinking about what people thought of her. Miss you, mum. I took that lesson. Now I try to live my best life with way less ducks to give. Relax. This stuff isn't so serious. I'm 3/4 is done with life. Probably 20 more to go, 10 good ones, and then it will start to get rough. Don't chase after things. Be simple. Eat simple. Enjoy life. Stop being critical. Enjoy this brief time. My dad was 51 when he passed away in 2007 of colorectal cancer. He said he had 2 regrets. One was he should have left his job years ago. He said he was so miserable the last 5 years there. It was wasted time when he could have been doing something he enjoyed. His job was a small family company whom he worked for 23 years. They treated him like absolute shit throughout his cancer ordeal. Second was he wanted to ask a woman friend of his out on a date and never got the courage to do it. This was so sad because my dad never went out with anyone when I was growing up. He must have really liked her a lot. He was about 2, and because he got his cancer diagnosis it was too late. His words stay with me. I was unhappy with my workplace and finally after many years will be moving on to a better position in September. Life is really too short. I wish I had been kinder to my husband. We bickered about small things that really weren't important. I wish I could tell him how sorry I am. Almost a decade after we last had any contact through lawyers about our divorce, I just managed to track down my ex-husband to apologize for how things ended. It went surprisingly well, and the feeling of absolution really does lift a huge weight off your shoulders. Assuming he still is alive, there is always an opportunity to say you're sorry. It took me a long, long time to realize that most people only do and say all the things they say and do to benefit themselves and their family. Ah, I'm seeing it, but as a teen relying on others to show me the ways of the world, it's hard not to take what everyone says at face value. Too many lies, too much conflicting information. I know to do research on what I'm told before trusting it, though, so there's that. I should have made better marriage choices. Don't marry too young, or if you do, just be really, really sure that you have the same values and same goals. If one of you doesn't want kids, for instance, that should be a deal breaker. If one doesn't like sex or intimacy, huge deal breaker. If he/she is a jerk to your friends and family, get out of that relationship. If he/she is never wrong, or will never admit it, get out. And stay out of credit card debt. I'm 62. Do what you want, and don't worry about what others think. You want to try that new restaurant, but have no one to go with? Go alone and enjoy yourself. Overweight but not swimming, because of how you look in a swimsuit? Who cares? Swim your heart out. Mouthing hymns in church, because you sing off key. Sing loud and make a joyful noise. But most importantly, be kind. Regardless of how anyone treats you, or what anyone says, be kind. You can walk away, disagree, and or not respect someone who doesn't deserve it, but do it kindly. Be argumentative or getting, but hurt or cursing and yelling only serves to make you feel worse later.